there's literally thousands and thousands of tons of discarded materials on this 18-acre site. This is only one pile.
From the early 1970s to 1995, the Marine Avenue site across the road from Willington Beach was used to operate a solid waste incinerator.
This is a giant glass pile. Not only glass, I see a battery up there, there's some window panes.
When incineration stopped, materials including ash, glass, tires, roofing, asbestos were left on site.
It's not very attractive, and even the tires are trying to roll out of here.
In 2017, the Powell River Regional District was awarded a $6 million grant to close and remediate the site and build a state-of-the-art resource recovery center and public green space.
We kind of envision Willington Beach to integrate and cross the road to have extra overflow parking, just sort of a greenway that comes and interweaves and works through the Resource Recovery Center and also projects itself further up towards through the forested lands to the complex. Powell River is at a bit of a crossroads with its solid waste management. Currently, we are exporting our solid waste 770 kilometers one way to Washington State to a landfill. We identified the opportunity to accomplish two things on the site, not only the remediation, but also the build out of a resource recovery center. Materials can be diverted from the waste stream for use by local artisans, for repair, and also will enable disposal of non-recyclable items as residual waste. For the Resource Recovery Center and residual waste transfer, we've studied many recently built sites to look for best practices and the build out of the facilities.
We have a placard explaining how the Perilous Road Recycling Center came to be, from an ash landfill, low temperature incinerator to a state-of-the-art recycling center. Well, where I'm standing now, I'm actually standing on 15,000 cubic meters of ash. We use the ash to provide fill for the entire site. All of the vegetation that we use for landscaping is all native species. We also have green roost on our scale house and our staff room. There's virtually nothing that's available to be recycled that you can't do here. All of our signage has an explanation of where a material goes. The first thing that you're going to do is you're going to check in at the scale house. And from there, you're going to do one of two things. You're going to go to the pay side of things, where we do charge for certain material. We charge for garbage, drywall, and wood. And that's to help cover the processing costs. Or if you have recyclable material, staff will direct you to the free side. We've got really easy access bays for vehicles. Lots of room to back up, and we have staff on site to help people sort their loads. The Perilous Road Center is definitely a big part of the local community. They're thrilled to have a facility where they're able to come and have a one-stop drop. They see their friends, they feel good about what they're doing with the material. They're not just throwing it in a black bag and it disappears forever. This place has good vibes.
Since this facility was all about facilitating zero waste, we wanted to design a facility that had as many green features as possible that walked the talk. Natural daylight, green roofs on the scale house and on the operations building, a geothermal energy, a slinky is how we get our heating and cooling, rainwater harvesting. The whole site actually has been landscaped to meet zero waste principles, and this facility, we did actually build it to LEED Gold standard.
As you can see, we have two transfer buildings. One is for commercial traffic only, to separate out the self-hauler, which is essentially residential traffic with small businesses. Do you want to walk right inside? When you go to unload your waste in the building, there is an attendant in there so that we can ensure that things go in the right place. Garbage and food waste is a huge attractant for birds in particular and other vectors. So for us, it's about keeping the facility clean, regular daily litter pickup. We make sure that the doors to the buildings are shut as often as possible.
Best management practices should be saying to the community, what we're trying to do is reduce emissions, garbage, etc. And so you should expect a clean site, an efficient site, a safe site.
Where we can, if we can incorporate anything on site into the buildings, when we remediate the glass pile, for instance, there might be opportunity in here that we can use some of the glass, you know, in the concrete work or just even for subsurface for some of the road grades. This site right now is, you know, deemed a contaminated site by the Minister of Environment, and we're struck with having to deal with it. But really, for us, once we remediate it, it's this incredible palette to build this vision. This opportunity doesn't come around to every regional district or every local government. We're really fortunate to have been awarded the $6 million, and here we are. We're going to be able to clean up the heart of Powell River and make it actually the green heart of Powell River. Unlock the gate, it's no longer a toxic site.